Shalom.
Shalom.
To start this lesson, we want to give our praises and glory to
Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahushai Ba'ashim Rechakodash.
Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and salutation to sincere brothers, pushing the truth and all true sincerity to go out the four corners of the earth, brings your lead. To you, we say Shalom.
Shalom.
All right, and you know, the Lord got us together in the Spirit, you know, fellowshipping through the Spirit. And on this fellowship night, you know, we're about to drop a sit down, and what we're going to go into is, you know, various topics through the Spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushai, because we got things we want to get into through the Spirit. All right? We got certain things we want to get into, and we're just going to let the Spirit of the Lord guide us, man. So, Lord's with us, sit down, is edifying.
Got it, brother. Come on. You know, we're going to let the Scripture speak, let the Spirit flow.
That's right.
You get that Ezekiel 3.
This is Ezekiel 3 and verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
All right, pause. So we're in that stead of being a watchman. Right. So, you know, when we're watching, we see certain things, we got to speak on it. Mm-hmm. You know, that's including the wickedness that's going on, including our enemies. Mm-hmm. All right, so you got jigging their feelings.
You know, why y'all ain't getting on us? You ain't doing this, doing that.
Because we're watchmen.
Right.
All right? We're watchmen into the house of Israel. So the Lord gave us jurisdiction to do this, authority. Right. We got the authority to do this from on high. Right. You got it, brother.
And it reads, therefore, hear the voice at my mouth.
The word.
Or hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me.
That's right. So we read the scriptures. Mm-hmm. And if it don't line up with the scriptures, guess what? There's a problem.
That's right.
There's a problem. All right? So that's when you hear the word that the Lord's mouth is here. Mm-hmm. And give them warning from me. So when you're going off, we tell you, man, repent.
Right.
You're going off.
Right.
You want to say something?
And that's an act of love. You know, just to bring that out as well. All right? That's an act of love. And, you know, the men that taught us, all right, the apostles, starting with Apostle Hart on down, the other men of Great Millstone, all right, you still see it being done to this day, all right? If something come out, brothers are quick to get on top of it, all right? Because we have to get on those individuals, man, all right? And that's a act of love, getting on them. And also, it's another thing, too, we getting on them, and it's like helping individuals that, you know, that have no guidance, so to speak, all right? Like young children, basically, man. Mm-hmm. Okay? Just wanted to say that.
That's right.
You know?
This is Leviticus 19 and 17. This is in the law. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
Mm-hmm.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him.
Right.
So I'm going to read this in the NLT to make it more plainly. Do not nurse hatred in your heart for any of your relatives. Confront people directly so you will not be held guilty for their sin.
Mm.
So the Lord, you're not supposed to do that.
Mm.
You see somebody talking that crazy shit and going off, you're supposed to say something about it, man.
That's right.
Or if not, the Lord going to deal with you, man.
Yeah.
You're not just supposed to go la-di-da-di-da. Oh, well, it ain't me. It ain't me.
No.
You know, it's going to be you.
Mm-hmm.
You got a lot of groups that ain't saying shit about what that man talked about, what he said. You got a lot of Israelites that ain't said not a peep. The Lord going to deal with y'all, man.
Yeah.
Right.
You got it, bro.
It's Jeremiah 1 and 10. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down, and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant. All right, so when we see these different men, you know, speaking falsely against the scriptures, okay, things they never read in the scriptures, we're supposed to pull down, throw down those false doctrines, man. Okay, as the true men of the Lord, we're supposed to do that. Because if we don't, with the sheep, they're gonna get led astray. They're gonna start thinking, oh, I could do that. You know, they said I could do that, and they could do that. Okay, but that's not our job, man. We're not supposed to lead the flock astray, man. Okay, it's called the truth for a reason.
That's right. Yeah. Shit, I gotta before I bring this priest up, I wanted to just back up what this brother said, man, because, you know, we gotta it's called a truth for a reason, all right? It's a truth for a reason, man. Okay, and I do want to bring out this priest up right quick, because the Lord has sent men out, all right? And the men that he has sent out, those are the men that's out here teaching you the real knowledge and understanding, man, okay? Those are the individuals you should take heed to, okay? Because you have individuals out here, these other individuals of these groups, the spirit of Yahweh Shimei HaShai is not on them, all right? That's plain. If you have, if you can see it, you can see it. The spirit of the Lord is not upon them, okay? And they're not feeding the people with knowledge and understanding, okay? I want to bring this out, this is Jeremiah 3:15, and I will give you pastors according to mine hearts, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. So the Lord going to give you individuals, certain men, all right? We're looking at two of the men right now, all right? In front of us. The Lord will give you certain men that's going to feed you with the true food. The food that's convenient. All right? The true need of your life. Mm-hmm. Not the GMO, all right? But the organic type of food, mm-hmm. All right? That's who the Lord sets up to teach you people, to teach our people, the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, all right? We have to tell you the truth. We're not supposed to, you know, just make up any fucking thing that comes into our mind, man, all right? And that's something I've been saying, and this brother Gabar knows about it, too. Hey, you people out here, you people are really, like, heartless. You people love to take a risk, man. Just saying any old fucking thing, man, okay? And the Lord don't play that, man.
The Lord speaks about adding and taking a
risk. That's the spirit. I was just thinking about that one morning.
There's a consequence for that.
Yeah.
So this guy, you know, speaking of his own words, he's supposed to be speaking the words of the Lord. Mm-hmm. You know, clearly, like the brother say, the spirit ain't on him.
Right.
He's not sent of the Lord.
Yep.
For him to tell his congregation, him being a leader of a congregation and telling them the things that he said,
yep,
he's going off big time. But somebody said they had a precept.
Now, I want to say something too, brother, because just to back you up, these people that are just saying anything they're saying, it shows that they don't love Israel. Mm-hmm. They don't love Israel. They don't love their fellow brothers, man. Okay? And, hey, if you don't love your fellow brother, you off, bro. You off.
Because you're basically leading the sheep astray.
That's right.
The Lord told Peter, which is the head of the church, you know, and he showed that all of it, because Peter's the head of the church, he showed him to feed my sheep. And he told him that three times adamantly.
Right.
Which is, knowing scripture, you know, that three times is the number of this.
Understand it. Right.
And the whole point and purpose of that is that to show the importance of feeding the sheep. So with this guy speaking the way he was speaking, he's leading the sheep astray.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He's not feeding them.
That's right.
You know, he's corrupting them. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
You know, he's supposed to speak out of the Bible when you speak to the congregation. You don't speak your own word. You speak the Lord's words. Because mm-hmm. it's not about you.
That's right.
It ain't about you. You got to speak these scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
You can make a point, but the whole thing is to use the scriptures and do it.
That's right.
And he didn't do that. So, you know.
Yep.
The scriptures say, well, you every idle word, that's you shall right. give an account.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I have a precept. This is Romans chapter 12, I'll start with verse 17. It says, recompense to no man evil for evil. Provide things honest in the sight of all men. If it be possible, as much as lieth in you, live peaceably with mm-hmm. all men. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine. I will repay, said the Lord. The Lord said, vengeance belongs to him. He will repay. So this guy telling Will, Chris Rock to go and, you know, commit adultery, you know, in the presence of Will Smith's son, you know, play video game and get some dope at the same time doing it. Man, how does this man still have a congregation? I don't get it.
All right.
But then the scripture do tell you about 2/3, so that's how we still have a congregation, even though the Lord is going to take who we're going to take out of these different congregations.
Mm-hmm.
But the two-thirds is a bigger number. But we only concerned about the elect.
Right.
The Lord willing be those men.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yep. Another thing about this individual, too, is, like, you know, You giving the whole breakdown on how to commit wickedness right
now. Right.
You giving the whole breakdown, bro. Man.
Well, that's why the scripture tell you you're supposed to be transformed.
Yep.
You know, by the renewing of your mind.
That's right, man.
You know, you're not even supposed... Oh, the scriptures tell you to let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth as well.
Yep.
That's going into preaching false doctrine as well. That's bullshit what he's saying.
Yep.
You know, going into how your conversation is supposed to change, which means your behavior, your speech.
Right.
And see, that's the reason why you have to be rooted in the word of the Lord, because the scripture speaks about not easily being blown away by every wind of doctrine. You got to be rooted, because at the end of the day, the scripture tells you, say, the Most High, the deceiver and the deceiver are his. Meaning, say, where the Lord say, it's for you to know the mysteries of the kingdom, you know, so you have to be able to discern. You know, that's what the other Apostle Gabal was going into. Now is the time that, especially the younger brothers coming in, you have to be able to discern who is the good teachers from who is the bad teachers. Because guess what? At the end of the day, even though this guy is saying what he's saying, it's the Lord who's making him say it. Because man's doing is of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. Let me see. All right. I have to back it up. Oh, this is Ezekiel, Baba Kashab. This is Ezekiel chapter 14 and verse 9. It says, and if the prophet be deceived when he had spoken a thing, I, the Lord, have deceived that prophet. And I will stretch out my hand upon him, and I will destroy him from the midst of my people Israel. So the Lord says, him who deceived that prophet, and he's going to stretch out his hand upon him,
yep,
and destroy him from out of the midst of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
So you see, this is not... it's not of us. It's the Lord's doing. The Lord controls everything.
Mm-hmm.
So remember, you have a one-third in the left and you have a two-third.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So it's set up like that for a purpose, for the people who the Lord doesn't want.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where our discernment comes in. You have to be able to discern.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we do what we're doing to give deliverance and make our call an election short. Because we won't be able to discern. We know straight off the break, that nigga going off, and we heard him open his mouth. We know he's going off.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But what you have? You have people in this congregation clapping.
Because they're not reading.
Right.
How do you know somebody they're going off? You read the Bible.
There you go. Right.
Did God say I can do this?
Right.
That's how you discern.
Right.
But you guys are not reading. You're listening, just listening.
That's right, for sure.
You're just listening. So you, what's going to happen? You eventually, the Lord going to get you, man.
Yeah.
Sure. You got more on?
Job, this is Job chapter 12 and verse 16. It says, with him is strength and wisdom. The deceived and the deceiver are his. So see, there you go. The Most High controls everything, man. Yeah, the Most High controls the man's goings of the Lord. You know? The Lord using them for who he don't want. So those people in that congregation who clapping their hand and ready to turn on wickedness. You have to give an account for every idle word.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly, you can see the spirit of the Lord ain't working with this guy.
Right.
He got a demon on him, man. He got a legion.
Mm-hmm.
You got a legion of demons on you, man.
Yep.
To even utter those type of words out of your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Like you don't even play with the Lord like that. You got
right.
No fear.
Right.
Those are words you don't even want to say in your own home by yourself.
The words like that, you don't even want them to come in your mind.
Mind.
You know?
Gone.
You by yourself in the crib and you just like, man, you got the mind of Chris Rock, you should go pause everything. Yahweh Bashem El Shai, Bubba Gashah, get this thought out of my fucking mind.
You know?
Those
demons overtook you. And those seven more hopped upon you, man.
Mm-hmm.
See? This is a perfect example. When seven more demons hop on you,
yep,
you become worse than before.
That's right.
This is a perfect example.
Mm-hmm.
What you got, brother?
I got something I want if you ain't
where?
Come. Romans 16 and 17, and I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord, Yahweh Shai Mashiach, but their own belly, and by good work, sorry, and by good words and and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple.
Hey, boy, that's a good scripture right there, mm-hmm. boy.
Yep.
Deceive the hearts of the simple.
you clapping. Right. It is. Like, he literally said it in, like I said, the fucking church. Like in the church, huh?
Like we in right. the demonic ass, you know?
Right.
And damn, man. Yeah,
it's just off, man.
This is 1 Peter 1 and 15. Mm-hmm. But as he which have called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. All right? That's so plain. That's plain, like the brother said. It says, be ye holy in all manner of conversation. Yep. So you're not supposed to even be talking like that, acting like that, thinking like that.
Yeah.
Right. Go ahead, hit that real quick.
This is Proverbs 17.
No, get the Romans 12. You was holding Romans 12.
Oh, yeah. Romans 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good, what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of the Most High.
There you go. So that you may prove what is good and acceptable. Mm-hmm. That's why. Mm-hmm. That you got to be able to discern. What's good and what's not good. Because if you don't, you are going to die.
Yep.
It is, we can't hold your hand and point, hey, you should do this. The scriptures tell you work out your own salvation.
Right.
Every man got to work it out. You got to work it out yourself, buddy.
Mm-hmm.
You got to know discernment. You got to know what's acceptable, like the brother that said, know that good and acceptable will of the Lord. You know, King David said, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Like the brothers were speaking up earlier, even those thoughts, you know, the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart. You know, it's another scripture would say, O Lord, Yahweh, keep up thy servant from presumptuous sins. Mm-hmm. You know? So you want what is acceptable. You want what you want the Most High to be pleasing, to be found pleasing of you. You know, by knowing what is his will. You have to give proper righteous judgment in the gate. You know? But this is Amos chapter 5 and verse 15. It says, hate the evil and love the good and establish judgment in the gate. It may be that the Lord power of hosts will be gracious unto the remnant of Joseph. So that's, you got to establish righteousness in the gate, man. That's it. You know?
I wouldn't tell a nigga in the world to go do new shit like that, man.
Right.
I made a video the other day and I said, this guy, at this point, this guy ain't fit to counsel a Billy Goat. he not fit to counsel a Billy Goat, bro. Who will take counseling from him?
I got a precept.
Go ahead, bro.
Good. This is Psalms chapter 34, verse 11. Psalms 34 verse 11. Come ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord Yahweh. What man is he that desireth What man is he that desireth life and loveth many days, that he may see good? 13, this is the point. Keep thy tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking guile.
Mm-hmm.
So keep the point. It says, keep thy tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking guile. All right. And I believe when you go to guile, it goes into deceit, and deceit is evil. Mm-hmm. So keep your lips from speaking evil, man. All right.
Evil communication, corrupt communication.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. This is a, you know, that's why you have to, continue to be a spiritual man.
Yep.
Because when you stray away from the spirit, you stray away into being a carnal, a beast, man. You know, that's why you want to continue to pray, continue to read, continue to do these things, because you see men have strayed away, man.
That's right.
They're gone.
Right. I got
you. You got it, brother.
It's 1 Timothy 4:1. First Timothy 4:1, it says, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils.
There you go.
And that man, that's a great example, man. Okay, he departed from the faith. Now what is he talking about, man? Okay, committing adultery, doing drugs. Okay, that's seducing spirits on him. Because it's not the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. Men of the Lord will never say some shit like that, man. Especially to the flock. Because right. They know the punishment of that. Right. You know, if they said some shit like that, Lord could kill them on the spot.
And that's another reason why guys do what they do. Because the Lord, he ain't really did nothing yet.
Right.
You know, because they think the Lord just up in heaven, you know, just chilling. But the Lord gonna do something, man. See, since sentence against the evil work isn't executed speedily, see, if the Lord would have smacked your ass as soon as you said that, you wouldn't have said that again. You would have repented. If every time we did something up, some brothers do get judged immediately. You know, the Lord might, you know, bang them up immediately because, you know, they're his son. You know? But you niggas, the Lord gonna let you, like Esau, pile your sins up. Where there ain't gonna be no way for you to get out. The Lord hate you, man. If he let you pile up your sins like that, he hates you, man.
That's right.
Your father ain't going to dare let you get away with stuff like that. That's why he's going to punish you and beat you. The Lord ain't punishing those guys, man. Those guys are highly exalted. They do it. This is their heaven.
Right.
Doing whatever they want. You can look at them, man.
Yeah.
The Lord don't love these niggas, man. You can tell.
Right.
They're not being chastened. They ain't sitting on high, just saying John the Baptist is this,
right.
Do this, cocaine, and
it's mad, bro. This evil. Like you're a super villain with power. Evil. You're shooting evil out of fucking hands, man. All right, it's like it's no fear of the Lord, and fear. Another thing I want to say too: fear doesn't only go into terror. Fear goes into reverence, respect, all right? If something's in the book, all right? The Lord say, this ain't cool, all right? That ain't cool. Because, once again, fear does not only go into being afraid, it goes into reverence, respect, man, all right? Fear, reverence, respect, man. Right. Fear the Lord, show reverence to the Lord, show respect to the Lord.
All right. The scriptures say obedience is better than sacrifice.
That's right.
The Lord ain't looking for your sacrifice. He's looking for you to be obedient.
That's right.
You see? Mm-hmm. Because if you're being rebellious, that means you're warring with the Lord.
That's right.
When you go into the world, that's what it means, right?
Say it again, brother.
Rebellion.
It means you go to war.
Yep. Going back to war with the Lord.
That's right. Mm-hmm. You got a quick one to back y'all up.
Cut it. Kabbalah got
Sirach 1:21. The fear of the Lord driveth away sin. And where it is present, it turneth away wrath.
Right.
So you want to keep a healthy fear of the Lord.
That's right.
That's it. Which is the whole duty of mankind. Ecclesiastes 12:13, right?
Right.
That's the whole duty. Keep the Lord's commandments. Fear the Lord and keep his commandments. That's right. The whole duty of mankind.
Ooh, let me jump down real quick. In verse 29.
And the first thing in Ecclesiastes 12:13, it says, fear the Most High before the commandments. Just seeing that,
Sirach 1:29. Be not an hypocrite in the sight of men, and take good heed what thou speakest.
Yep.
Take heed of what you speakest. Exalt not thyself, lest thou fall and bring dishonor upon thy soul.
Yep.
And so God will discover thy secrets and cast thee down in the midst of the congregation, because thou camest not in truth to the fear of the Lord. But thy heart is full of deceit.
Right.
And you see it.
Mm-hmm.
See it, man.
That's right.
You got it,
Kabar. I'm going to read this out real quick. This is Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. Mm-hmm. You know, ultimately, when you have the fear of the Lord, you have the understanding, you understand that certain things not going to be pleasing to the Lord. That's why you got to move in a certain way, especially if you preaching out to the flock. You know, you don't want to lead the flock astray. You know, I got another precept back up. Like I just said, this is Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 1. It says, woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pastor, said the Lord Yahweh Bashimah Shad. And that first word says, woe means it's destruction. You know, so all these things that these so-called camps, they doing is, you know, the Lord sees it. You know, the Lord will punch them, the Lord will ultimately destroy them, you know. These things are not just going to be unseen, you know.
Right. I got something to back you up, brother.
Slack your back. I just want to say something. Because you said, you talked about Peter and Yahweh Shai earlier, that John 21, I believe. Mm-hmm. The Lord said, if you love me, feed my sheep. He asked, well, I should say this. He asked Peter, do you love me? Peter said, yes. He said, feed my sheep. Right? So if you love the Lord, you got to be feeding the sheep.
Action.
Right.
Love is an action.
Right. Mm-hmm. These niggas don't love the Lord. Because you're not feeding the sheep.
You're feeding them bullshit.
Right, you're feeding them bullshit.
What the hell are you feeding them?
Right.
Fucking gummy worms.
Right. And fucking
sheep's not supposed to eat gummy worms, man.
Skittles.
And fucking Takis.
Right.
And hot Cheetos and shit, man.
Right.
They're supposed to eat grass.
Right. Right.
Don't sheep eat grass?
Right. I look up at the day. How much time do sheep eat a day? They have a term called grazing.
Right.
And they graze for 7 hours. 7 hours out of the day.
And the 8-7 completion.
There you go. Spirit. That's right.
Well, you feed them fucking whatever the fuck you feed them, man. Sour patches and shit.
Right.
Right. And then again, taking a break, 6 months, 1 year, your sheep gonna die.
Right.
Of starvation?
Right. Okay,
unless your sheep get away to another shepherd.
Right.
You know?
Right.
The Lord sent another shepherd because the sheep need to be fed.
Yeah. And that proves how much you don't love the sheep.
Right.
You know? If you just starve them out for that long, man.
You know? Or if you corrupted the sheep.
Right.
Because you could be present too and corrupting them.
Mm-hmm.
Not feeding them with things convenient for them.
Yeah.
You feed them bullshit.
Yeah.
Feeding them with necessities, man.
Right.
Yeah. The nutrients, the real nutrients. They're nutritious deficient, what they call it?
Nutritionally deficient.
There you go. Mm-hmm. They're not getting the nutrients that's what
Esau are doing to us.
Yep.
With these GMOs.
really, to be under the Lord keeping us alive.
That's right.
You know, not to change the subject.
That's right.
Because we're not even eating real food, man.
That's right.
So really, it's the Lord's mercies we are not consuming.
That's right. All this
bullshit, we supposed to be dead, man.
Mm-hmm. But see, all the scriptures talk about all these things, but just like you said, it's the Lord who keeping us alive. Because the Lord said, even shall the children of Israel eat their defiled bread among the Gentiles. Okay. So this was already prophesied that would happen. But the Lord's still going to keep his remnant.
Yeah. That's right.
Mm-hmm. It's the Lord who keeping us. You got it. You spot on. It's the Lord who keeping us.
Yeah.
We need the kingdom. We need the God. This place is polluted. The Lord said this place is polluted.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, we're going to see even. Hey, as the end of the world comes, we're going to see worship.
That's right.
We're going to see more shit. We're going to hear crazy shit, more crazy. Because we're at the end.
That's right.
So men's intent, their heart, is going to be revealed.
Yeah.
In the end.
That's what's happening more and more.
Yeah.
That's why this guy jumped out the box.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's why he jumped out the box. The scripture says, who could resist his will? That was supposed to happen. That's why it happened. And that's why brother's talking about it.
That's right. Yeah. Now you're going to see who are the true prophets of the Lord.
Yep.
See, when there was a problem, the prophets came on the scene. When you read the Bible, the Lord sent the prophets out to go do what? To go rebuke, reprove people.
Mm-hmm.
When there was always a problem, the Lord sent, he got a special group of men that he's always had.
Right.
You know, when Esau got a problem, he sent out certain guys,
yep.
go handle this mission.
Right.
Well, that's what the Lord got with his prophets.
Mm-hmm.
When there's a problem, he sent them out. Right. That's why you guys hate the problem. Who got something?
I got something. But you go ahead.
God got 1 Samuel 16, 4. And Samuel did that which the Lord Yahweh spake, and came to Bethlehem. And the elders of the town trembled at his coming.
Yep.
And said, comest thou peaceably? And he said, peaceably, I have come to sacrifice unto the Lord Yahweh. Sanctify yourselves. And come with me to sacrifice. And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to sacrifice. Right. They asked Samuel if he came peaceably, man. Because, you know, as Brother said, when the prophets came to town, he came to rebuke. Okay, so if the elders came, like, you know, you came peaceably, you know, they want to know if there was a problem or not. Okay, because if a prophet comes to town, that mean, you know, there was only 1 minute for that son bash when it happened.
So you got a group of men getting on a specific problem. The Lord's got them doing that.
Right. That's a spirit.
Oh, you hate. Well, I guess you call the Lord a hater. You guess, because we call ourselves? We call ourselves the men of the Lord.
Right.
We all agree we don't have free will.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So what's going on? There's a problem. Give me Revelation 18 real quick. Where it says, rejoice over her thou the men of the Most High are here on the planet Earth. I'm gonna prove that. All these men they're back.
Yep.
Alright, you guys can pull, if you wanna add on to that, you can give me Revelation 10. You can give me Daniel, where you say you're gonna prophesy again.
Okay.
The men of the Lord, they're back.
Spirit, go ahead,
get that.
Revelation 10.
Yeah.
I'll
get Revelation 10.
What's that's like
20. 20?
Yeah.
20? Okay. This is Revelation 18, verse 20. Rejoice over her, though heaven.
Rejoice over her is talking about Babylon the great whore.
Go ahead.
That's right.
And ye holy apostles.
And ye what?
And ye holy apostles and prophets.
Oh!
What?
Read that again. Go look! These men are here on earth!
Mm-hmm.
The men that we're reading in the Bible are walking this earth right now.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Rejoice. I'll read again. Rejoice over her, thou heaven, and ye apostles and prophets, for the Most High hath avenged you on her. And a mighty angel took up a stone.
That was the point. That was the point. So they're back here, and they're cursing people out. The 12... Daniel, John, all these great men, Ezekiel, they're here, man. Go ahead, you must go ahead. Yeah.
I got Daniel 12 and 13. But go thy way to the end be, for thou shalt rest and stand in thy lot at the end of the day. For thou shalt rest and stand in thy lot at the end of the days.
There you go. We're at the end of the days right now. Mm-hmm. Daniel's in his lot, cursing people out. He's a prophet.
Revelation 10 and 11. And he said unto me, thou must prophesy again before many peoples and nations and tongues and kings. So yeah, the angel telling John the Revelator, you don't have to prophesy again. You know, that's now, that's in these times.
That's right.
You're going to need to come back.
So the prophets are here, man.
Mm-hmm.
So it's up to you to figure out, all right, where the real men at?
Right.
They're cursing people out. They were rebuking, they were proving, they're edifying, exhorting.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So let's make, there ain't no confusion about this thing. You got it, brother?
Come on.
You got
something? Shit, I'm looking at it.
Okay, if you ain't got nothing.
Now that brother's got it. Go ahead.
What you got?
I got 2 Timothy 4.
Hold on, I want you to get this real quick.
1 Kings 22.
Get that 1 Kings, yeah.
This 1 Kings 22 and verse 8. And the king of Israel said unto, Jehoshaphat, there is yet one man, Micaiah, the son of Amilah, by whom we may inquire of the Lord Yahweh, but I hate him.
But he what?
But I hate him.
What? Let's see why he hates him.
For he does not prophesy good concerning me.
Because he does not what?
Prophesy good concerning me.
So the prophets were always hated.
Right.
He said, he told him. He said straight out,
right.
I know he's a man of God. I know he's a man of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai.
Right.
But I hate him.
Right.
Go to say, Jake, wicked as fuck, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Jake don't care about what the Lord got to say. Jake is in his emotion. I don't like him.
Yeah. Yeah,
because right. He prophesied not good concerning me. Well, it's not him. He's just a messenger.
He's
right.
Speaking the truth. I'm about to come in because I've told this
to this is Galatians chapter 4, verse 16. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
Mm-hmm.
And like I always like to say, bro, we have become a lot of our people's enemy, bro.
Wow.
Even bro, it's so bad. We're our parents look at us as enemies. Our so-called loved ones, our cousins, all right, so on and so forth, they look at us as enemies, man. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Another serious account to back up the brother with the account we just read, that's how John the Baptist got his head chopped off.
Mm-hmm.
Because he told, what's the lady name again? Herodia, I believe.
A nigger woman.
Yeah. Because she was wrong for taking her husband's brother, I believe.
Yes, she was. Yep.
And she had his head chopped off.
Mm-hmm.
Is yep. Because the king said, I'll give you anything you want.
Right, a daughter. Oh,
and I ain't killed John.
Right.
Yeah.
Because John told her the truth.
Yep.
She hated John. She wanted his hat. And then charge him.
So we're in good company, though. We're hated. We're going to be all right, man.
Right.
Because the whole prophets were hated. Yahweh say, you are those that killed the prophets.
Right.
Go ahead. You can get that?
Yes.
Come. You can go ahead and find that.
Yeah, I think it was she slept with the brothers. I believe so.
Right, I'm trying to get her name. I'll get the comment.
But you go
ahead and read that.
Yeah, you go ahead.
All right, you got something?
All right, Kabar got something.
Go ahead, Kabar.
This is Matthew 5, verse 10. It says, blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye which men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because, you know, at the end of the day, people, especially in these times, because, you know, how, you know, in GMS, our apostles, it started with our apostles and elders, they'll constantly get on, you know, on these other camps because not because they, you know, hate them or things of that sort, it's because out of love, you know, mm-hmm. because they want to correct them, because honestly, we can see that they're going off.
Right.
You know, and they want to say all these sort of kind of things, but ultimately it's up, you know, these men are doing it because of the Lord. You know, it's up the Lord the men are doing these things.
Right. That's back to what you said. They don't hate us, they hate Yahweh Shem Al-Shai. Because we're like we're acting like as representatives, as the men of the Lord. So you whatever you're saying to us, you're basically saying to Yahweh Shem Al-Shai, man.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true. If I send somebody to go drop off some flowers to my woman, and you cursing them out, I made them go there, man. You know, just using an example.
Right.
Well, look.
Fuck you cursing them
what
out.
What the fuck? I sent them over there.
Right.
So you gotta take that up with the boss.
Right.
Okay? The boss is you. How about you? Right. Y'all shy.
Right.
So the boss hears you, man.
Right.
So fuck you. Right. You don't like it? The message? The boss is gonna kill you, man.
Right. I just came to drop off a package.
That's it! Hey, you know the Amazon? Hey, Amazon nigga come drop your package. Hey, the FedEx man, let's say the FedEx man come to y'all and drop the package. You don't talk to the FedEx man and say, hey man, this is not what I ordered. He just kinda dropped the fucking package off, nigga.
I'm just doing my job.
Look, man, you gonna go fucking kill FedEx man because your package wrong?
Right.
You gotta take that up with the company.
Right.
He just had to drop it off.
Right.
You niggas are gonna die, man. And it's no nice way to say it.
I got an account with Herod real quick.
God.
Because I wanted to get that name correct. Her name is Herodias.
God, yeah.
This is Matthew chapter 14 and verse 6. It says, but when Herod's birthday was kept, the daughter of Herodias danced before them and pleased Herod, whereupon he promised with an oath to give her whatsoever she would ask.
Mm-hmm.
And she being therefore instructed of her mother said, give me John the Baptist's head in a charger. And the king was sorry.
He was sorry. Why?
Yeah.
Because he knew John was a man of the Lord.
Right.
He knew it.
That's right.
Everybody knew John was a man of God. Mm-hmm. That's why he was seeing like, fuck, man.
Right.
Damn. Because he made an oath.
Yeah, right.
See, in the ancient world, your word was your bond.
Yeah.
In the ancient world, things were different. You couldn't just say something and not do it in the ancient world.
Mm-hmm. You look at you different.
Exactly.
In the sight of all men, you said it to open
up
in front of because that was a big gathering.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's how it was in the ancient world.
Mm-hmm. Now,
your words were very powerful, man.
Right. It says, and the king was sorry, nevertheless, for the oath's sake,
mm-hmm.
and them which sat with him at meat, he recommended it to be given her, and he sent and beheaded John in the prison, and his head was brought in a charger and given to the damsel, and she brought it to her mother. Her mother set up the whole thing.
Yeah.
Why? Because he tell her she wronged for getting rid of her husband's brother.
You think he said it nice? Yeah, you know, man, you wrong.
No, John was a rough man.
Yeah.
John, read about John, he was at the Campbell's, hair on him, and eating locusts and honey. Mm-hmm. You think John was saying, hey, you know, you can't do that. No, John said, man, you going off, man.
Right.
He was cursing them out.
Right.
When the scribes and the Pharisees came to his baptism, he cursed them out.
Yep.
He said, what the hell are you doing here?
Right.
What you doing here, man? Mm-hmm. So John, he was a prophet, man.
That's right.
All right, he ain't come to play fucking games.
That's right. And John had a job to do.
Exactly, man.
Right.
The prophets ain't come to play no fucking games, man.
John had a package to deliver it, right? And he delivered it, right? And then when he was done working, he clocked out.
Exactly.
All right?
Mm-hmm. His work was finished.
His work was finished.
I guess so.
Come on, bro. It happened with John the Baptist. Happened with Paul.
Yahushua.
Yep. Right.
They killed Yahushua. They lied on him.
Right.
I mean, even though it was already through the Spirit,
right.
But they did the same thing to Yahushua, but worse.
Yep.
Lied on him.
Yep.
Blasphemy. Right. He committed blasphemy.
Yep.
Damn. What did he do? He was perfect.
Even Pilate said, what has this man done? What crime have he did?
Right.
Yeah. Pilate said, I washed my hand of this man's,
I'm clean. I ain't got nothing to do with it. Basically, I ain't got nothing to do with it. Y'all gonna do what y'all gonna do.
Right. And shit, you know, going back to what I was saying, because them brothers brought out some points. And going back to Paul, because, hey, Paul, he delivers his package, and it was time for him to check out. When it was time for him to check out, man. Okay? So, you know, the men of the Lord, they job, it's like everybody's working at FedEx or Amazon. We all just dropping off a package, all right, till it's time to clock out, man.
That's right.
All
right?
If you get mad at us, hey, this is my route for today. This is all the bucks I got. This is the addresses. I'm just coming to do what I gotta do. That's it.
Bro. Yeah, you still gonna have to get mad. You're gonna tell you the truth.
Right.
But I hate him.
We're not prophesying good against you niggas.
Right.
We're telling you you're gonna starve. You're gonna eat your children. Right. The beasts of the field coming out. Hurricanes, tornadoes.
Yep.
What? How the fuck are we gonna say that in a nice way?
Right.
There ain't no nice way.
Ain't no nice way to tell you that, man.
Right. I guess so. You can't tell nobody in a nice way.
Fuck you people.
You can't, bro.
Fuck y'all, man. To hell with y'all. The Lord is going to, he going to fucking sweep clean you niggas, man.
You got something back yet, brother?
Go ahead, bro.
Jeremiah chapter 15 and verse 1. It says, then said the Lord unto me, though Moses and Samuel stood before me, yet my mind could not be toward this people. Cast them out of my sight. And let them go forth. And it shall come to pass, if they say unto thee, whither shall we go forth? Then thou shalt tell them, thus said the Lord, such as are for death to death, and such as are for the sword to the sword, and such as are for famine to the famine, and such are for the captivity to the captivity. And I will appoint over them four kinds, said the Lord, the sword to slay, and the dogs to tear, and the fowls of the heaven, the beasts of the earth to devour and to destroy.
That's right.
That's what you was just going into.
That's right.
The Lord ain't playing no games. We live in a judgment time.
Yeah,
he ain't playing no games.
Hey, you gonna wish somebody curse your ass out, man. When you see
it right.
When you see what the hell. See, we here, we already see it. We already see what the Lord about to do. That's why we here. We already see the Lord ain't some his children. He gonna have to show them, like,
yeah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
Us, we already know the Lord ain't no joke.
Yeah, that's right.
But y'all don't see it, man. Mm-hmm. So you gonna wish that we was here cursing you out. Some of y'all gonna wish that we actually punched y'all in the face to get it. When you actually see, bro, you're gonna starve to death. Do you understand how severe that is?
And Apostle Paul said that, man, though I be rude in speech but not knowledge.
Right.
So you wish that we didn't curse you or so you could get it right.
You people are going to be in anguish like, oh my God, I'm so fucking hungry.
Right.
Yeah. man.
Yeah, why didn't you listen to those Israelites on the corner? Where are those Israelites?
Snot bubbles
coming.
Snot bubbles. It might not be none. You might be that dehydrated.
Right. Yeah, looking pathetic.
No, pitiful case.
Right. They're going to be crying over
trying to see your son coming down and your shit coming down.
If it's something to do, you're going to eat it because you're going to be hungry.
Right.
Let's get that pitiful case, man.
Hey, Kabar got a quick precept, though.
This is Isaiah chapter 58. You know, just back with my brother. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 1, it says, cry aloud, spare not. Mm-hmm. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet and shew my people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. But also focus on our part that says, cry aloud, spare not. Because at the end of the day, we're not saying, you know, we're not on the highways and byways speaking these smooth, like tones. We actually crying loud, you know, projecting our voice because our hell about to break loose. For example, if a car, you about to get hit by a car, we're not going to tell you, pat you on the shoulder, hey, you about to get hit by a car. No, we're going to scream at you.
Right.
You know, because at the end of the day, we understand that the scriptures talk about all these things that are about to come in past, famines, you know, women's getting ravished. And
bro, the leaders are telling you this. Uh-huh. Joe Biden told you this. Right. So you going to listen to him? Right. If you don't listen to us, you gonna listen to the goddamn devil.
Right.
He's telling you what he's gonna do.
you trusting him so much, you might as well listen.
The devil told you, hey, man, you know, food gonna get real scarce out here.
And don't be surprised if your president tells you, man, hey, man, you women stay indoors, man. Start staying indoors. Don't be fucking surprised, man.
Wearing all them bubblegum pants and shit.
Right.
That's gonna stop.
Right. Them damn yoga pants.
Yoga pants, booty shorts, the bonnet, the short, the crop tops, the fucking down here these hoes like to wear the Etika fucking shit.
Yeah, all that tight shit.
It's gonna come to naught, man.
Oh yeah.
You know how long the scripture's been telling them a long time ago women should be dressed in modest apparel.
Right.
And that's when they were put on modest apparel.
Yep. Yeah.
They have these long garments.
Yep. Hey, me personally, man, I send my woman all them the fierce, creepy rape neutrals articles. Hey man, send y'all woman them articles, man. Right. Let them know this shit ain't no fucking game out here, man.
Really?
Women getting fucking raped and beat up. Hey, man, look. No, but it's real.
You're right.
Send them shits to your woman, man.
It's real.
So they can see, like, oh my gosh. I told my woman before I got here how the woman got robbed and her arm fell off because she was being dragged. My woman, oh my God, yeah, yes, oh my God. You're going to hear that, oh my God.
That's right. Yeah, just the other day when they had the 18 people shot in California,
yeah,
Sacramento, the minute I saw it, I saw the video with the shooting, a woman in the video said, what just happened?
Oh, yeah.
Said, what just happened? That shot them beating rapid thing, boom, boom, boom. You see?
That's going to be
all around these places.
1,000.
Yeah.
Yep.
In Jacob's trouble.
That's right. See, like I like to say, man, the Lord been putting a spirit upon me to say this for about a couple months to a year now. Things intensify. All right, you already seeing women getting raped here and there. You see somebody die. You know, today, these things are going to increase on a whole nother fucking level.
That's right.
These things like you're going to be seeing. It's a point. Things are going to be happening every hour. Every hour is going to lead to every 30 minutes. It's gonna lead to boom, boom, back to back.
That shit gonna be
it's gonna
crazy.
Get really ugly out here, man.
Yep.
All right.
Oh, 2 Timothy 3:1.
Yep. Come on. Shit, my hey, I'll grab it.
All right, put it on.
That's good. Hey, this shit about to be like you said. It's going. It's going. It gotta intensify.
Right.
It's going to intensify into the worst time ever.
That's right.
Like we're living in the worst. We're gonna be living in the worst time ever.
Right.
Ever.
Real quick, the precept.
Time like never before.
Isaiah chapter 13, it says, everyone that is found shall be thrust true. And everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword. So even our old people who join unto the devil, they're going to fall by the sword. This is the point, verse 16. The back of the brother's point that they're making that this is just not our words. This is coming out of the Holy Bible. The scripture is telling you this. Isaiah chapter 23, verse 16, it says, their children also shall be dashed to pieces mm-hmm. before their eyes.
Right.
Their houses shall be spoiled and their wives ravished. Right. So we're not just making this up. This is in the scripture. We're not just saying this.
Right.
Okay? Ravish is just a pretty word for saying rape. Mm-hmm. That's in the scripture. The scripture mm-hmm. tells you this is the time that we're coming into. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 1, and this know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. Perilous, when you go into the word, it means dangerous, hard, fierce, savage.
Dangerous.
Look it up.
Savage. Oh, it's going to be dangerous to go to the supermarket mm-hmm. by yourself.
Yeah.
Food gets scarce. Food going to be the new money.
Yeah.
You think an old woman going to be able to go to the supermarket by herself? Oh, man. She's going to get her ass beat the fuck up.
Right.
For them groceries. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
It's going to happen, man. Mm-hmm. People about to get real beast-like out here. Savage, like your brother was saying. No sending them words.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me get that precept real quick. Second, mm-hmm. that's a chapter 15. Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. Let's lock it.
This is 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1.
No, he just read that.
I quoted it.
Okay, come.
You can go ahead.
This is 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1. This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come.
Mm-hmm.
For men shall be lovers of their own selves, mm-hmm. covetous, boasters, proud, mm-hmm. blasphemers, mm-hmm. disobedient to parents, mm-hmm. unthankful, yep. unholy.
Unholy.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's the time that we're entering in right now.
Yep.
That's the time that we're in. Okay? So back to the brother Paul, where he was just saying how food will become new money. Right now, we a lot of times we pick up little things from the store, but most of the time you send your woman to the store to pick up little things or whatever. This time she gonna be afraid to go to the store.
Yep.
You as the man gonna have to go look about the food.
Yep.
You know,
but that's gonna lead. I'm gonna talk to you real quick. That's gonna lead to your woman getting in order when she actually see these things happen.
Yeah, that's right.
She gonna snap her ass into a fucking Slim Jim mm-hmm. when she sees somebody get. Fucking crack across their skull
right.
for some milk.
That's right.
For some damn milk and yeah. chips, man. Right. Will she see that? Oh, honey.
Right.
Yeah.
That pretzel gonna turn into a Slim Jim. all out of order gonna turn into order. But just the back of the brother, I'm one, man, because this is not our words. This is the scriptures, bro.
Right.
All
right.
And the Lord tells us to prophesy to you people these things, so. Whether you hear it or not, too. So, mm-hmm. this is 2 Ezra 15 and 1. Behold, speak doubt in the ears of my people, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. So the words of Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai are faithful and true. They going to come to pass. They going to come to pass. You got Isaiah 55. All right, none shall return unto me void, roughly paraphrasing. Okay, so these things will come to pass, man. All right, you seeing it happening now, you don't think it's gonna continue and get worse? All right, come on, bro.
I got some.
Good.
This is Daniel 12 and 1. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince was standing for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation even. To that same time, and at that time that people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book. Mm-hmm. Right? It's gonna be a time so bad that Michael has to come down, man. You're talking about an angel, you know, of Yahweh Shem Shai coming down, okay? Because that's how bad it's gonna be. You know, those that are gonna get delivered are the elect.
That's right.
Okay, so hey, the rest of these niggas, y'all go die, man. You women, hey, y'all go get ravished, man. Okay.
Yes, the black woman is going to get ravished, man.
Yep.
All right. The black woman is going to get ravished. So-called the Latino woman is going to get ravished. You women of the nations are going to get ravished, man.
The black queen. The goddess.
Goddess.
The black woman is God.
Right.
Yeah, that.
She's going to get. They're going to have their way with her, then kill her after, man.
And eat her.
Kill her and eat her, man.
Fucking eat her, man.
We're coming into some horrible times, bro. Even, you know, we talking about, we laughing about it, like, bro, what was like, oh my gosh, you know?
It's going to be worse than that.
Right. Well, yeah, when we talk about, you know?
Right. Niggas going to be horny and hungry, man.
Yep.
Hey, yeah.
Yep. you know?
A piece of meat, you know? Right.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Niggas growling this right. Shit. A pack of niggas.
You guys are some double H niggas. You're some double H niggas.
A pack of three big black niggas, man. Right. Just hungry as hell.
Right.
And horny.
Hungry and horny, baby.
What boy?
It's gonna get bad, bro. It's gonna instead of a pack,
let's get wool. Somebody give me Isaiah 4:1.
That was a quick one.
God, you got it, brother.
Second answer 15 and 19. It says a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor.
What that means? What does pity mean? Please no, don't kill me. I have 5 children. I have a grandson. Fuck you, man. Give me this fuck. That's what that means.
Right.
I'm doing it for 20. Shut the fuck up and give me this food, man. That's what. See, we gotta get.
Yeah.
We gotta show you what that means.
That's right.
Cause Jake. Fucking doesn't see. I'm realizing the Mormon is true how stupid Jake is, man.
Con.
I understand now. You guys are fucking stupid.
Yep.
You guys are dumb. The Lord called you stupid, man.
Yep.
You're impudent, hard-hearted, sottish.
Yep.
No pity, meaning no, I don't care if I've known you 30 years.
Connected.
I don't care if I've known you 100 years. However fucking long you've known your neighbor.
No fucking mercy.
It ain't gonna be no pity. The Lord is going to put that beast-like spirit into these people.
Right.
Yeah. That's what that means.
Somebody can find that too. Then shall they fight against one another.
God damn.
Friends shall fight one against one another. Right.
Right.
Nope. I got some.
Second Edges 15.
You still got more on one?
Yeah, I don't remember one.
Okay, come on.
Second Edges 15 and 19. It says, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword.
Yep.
We know the sword is the modern day sword is the gun.
Yep.
And spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation. So a lot of this is going to be because of the lack of food, which your president told you that this is going to be, the shortages of food are going to be real.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And the Bible, that's called famine.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. You see? Mm-hmm. So we ain't making this up. This is straight out of the scriptures, man.
Right, when people are hungry, they don't act like themselves.
Oh, that's right. I'll make a point on that. I'm bad to you. When you're actually hungry, there's something in your body called adrenaline.
God,
so when you reach to the point of where your body's going to tell you that I need to eat or I'm going to die, adrenaline rushes through your body, and you get like super. You get superhuman fast. You get stronger. So your body is feeding you the last little bit of energy it got just to eat.
Right.
So you're going to actually see superhuman people out here running after people.
Yep.
That zombie shit, that shit real.
Black summer.
Mm-hmm. That shit is real. Like, go, if you don't believe me, go look it up.
Right.
Go look it up. Mm-hmm. People turn into superhumans because your body is telling you, I need to eat to survive.
Right.
So you're going to have people with heightened senses actually looking around.
Right.
Oh, there she go. Now, jumping fences to go eat people.
Right.
You're going to hear everything. You're going to hear the air go across the plants. Right. You're going to be superhuman.
Yeah, yeah.
If you've ever fasted for a long period of time, you know.
Yeah, that's right.
You know. That, like, this is shit is real, man.
Right. I think it was an Edomite on a podcast. He said he basically went on a fast for 3 days. He said you can hear, I think he said a pin. Or
that's like, what I'm saying. Like, this shit, dark. People want to be, this, what we're about to see is going to be so fucking unreal.
Mm-hmm. Right. Another thing, too, a brother once shared it. I heard it, too. You know, you go on a fast for a long period of time, for like a 3-day fast, it's like your stomach will start burning. That's another thing that will happen. So, all that can come together into effect, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Yeah, bro. Esau has fucking
shown. It's continuing on in the worst times ever. Go ahead. You got it.
This is. Let me get up there. This is Isaiah 4:1. And in that day, 7 women shall take a hold of one man.
That day, going into that time of trouble.
That's right.
Okay.
Because
the woman ain't going to cleave to a man of the Lord now. Mm-hmm. 7:1. They ain't going to go down like that because the woman, she's living in pleasure.
Mm-hmm. We the losers right now.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, we're the losers right now. You know, to them, I should say.
Yep.
You know.
we lame.
Right.
You know, because we trying to live a righteous, quiet life.
That's right. But hey, real soon, Yahweh Bashim and Al-Shai will make us shine, man.
Yeah. Okay. That's right.
You got it, brother.
Saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach.
Mm. That's right. To take away their reproach. So they're going to run to a man of the Lord. Then, you know, the Lord is going to start the change of worlds. Mm-hmm. Really, really is happening now, but it's going to be, like the brother always says, going to intensify.
Sure.
People are going to start recognizing, like as this age ends,
yep.
You are going to, like, people are going to realize your spirit, man.
That's right.
People are going to realize who you are.
That's right.
That you brothers see it now when you walk inside stores and people just stare at you.
Yeah.
Y'all see it? I already know y'all see it. So it's just like they don't know you, but it's your spirit in you. They know you.
There's something different about
this. Exactly.
That's the spirit. That's
like
spirit.
They know that you're not a normal person. Why? Because you most likely your brothers are part of the elect, man.
Right.
It's because remember. The elect are the right. Best spirits created.
That's right, brother. That's right.
That's who the elect are.
That's right.
The Lord created Yahweh Shai created the best spirits ever.
That's on right.
The earth. And they're above all the spirits on the earth.
That's right.
So that's why they all looking at you and all like, damn, what's up with hell?
Right.
You know?
Right.
But not to get off topic. Yep. You know? But
that was needed. You finished?
Definitely.
I got something. This is Isaiah 32, verse 2. And a man shall be as in hiding place from the wind, and a covert from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. So a man, and not just a regular old man, a man of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, is going to be a hiding place from the wind, and that wind goes into destruction, man. All right? Just a precept with that brother, man. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Real quick, Isaiah 13 and 12.
Spirit.
I will make a mind more precious than fine gold.
Yep.
Even a mind that than the golden wedge of Ophir.
You read that again, Balkishaw.
Isaiah chapter 13 and verse 12. I will make a mind more precious than fine gold.
Mm.
Even a mind than the golden wedge of Ophir.
So he's going to turn you basically because the celebrities are looked at like that nowadays.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the Lord gonna turn you into a celebrity.
Yep.
Like everybody gonna see you and say, Oh my God, I need to come, I'm coming with you.
Right.
I'm coming with you. I ain't going, I'm coming with you.
Yeah.
Like the woman was following Denzel in Book of Eli.
Yep.
She was following with him.
Yep.
What you gonna have a whole bunch of nigga women behind you following you, man.
Right.
That's why Apostle Ball, you say about that stick.
Right, that stick.
That stick, you have to get these bitches off with you,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, you're right, man. Oh, you really gonna be that celebrity.
The Lord said he gonna make you more precious than fine gold.
Right.
So the Lord is just getting ready to transform us, brothers.
That's right. And not to cut you off sloppy, right, brother. The more you grow in this truth, and the more the Lord deal with you. Now you understand what the men of the Lord tell you are saying. I should say, by for example, don't worry about these women, man. Isaiah 4:1's coming. All right, because the Lord's about to make you shine, man.
Yep.
All right, He's about to make you shine. All you gotta do is be patient and keep pleasing the Lord, and you gonna shine, man. All right.
Yep.
You gonna shine, man.
Yeah. Don't worry about the naked glory. That shit is vain.
Right.
What the Lord really is about to do for you, right. You brothers out there, that's gonna be nothing.
It's gonna top date shit.
Right. That's why we always say, the Lord's, you gonna be a superhero to your family.
That's right.
Then your children gonna understand why you went out every, you know, that's your right. woman gonna understand.
That's right.
You know, man, time. Look, she gonna understand in that day.
That's right. That's
your
right.
children, your woman.
Right.
The same way, Noah, you kept building the ark.
Right.
In that day, that's when Noah was the king.
That's right.
He was star.
That's when she understood, oh my gosh.
Right.
My man, he's a man of God.
Right. That's when the jaw
dropped. The jaw dropped.
And the eyes opened. Oh.
Yep.
Yep.
Well, that's what the day we're waiting for.
That's right.
Because they don't understand now.
That's right.
You know, they think, you know,
right. Oh, it's fucking bum. It's a bum. The bum never has time for
you. You gotta line up.
No, you don't gotta line up.
You gotta line up.
Never home.
Never home and shit.
All right, you gonna see it real soon.
Always talking about that Bible.
Right. You gonna see it real soon, man.
Always talking about that Bible. You got the wrong interpretation. What? When you see him bitches get raped and crack across the head, ain't gonna be no termination then.
He ain't got me no bum.
You know what I'm saying?
You see any children, things happen to children. Sweet old children.
Sweet old little babies.
Grandma and grandpa, they just
on crack.
Throwing grandma off the wheelchair.
Yeah, kicking them out of the wheelchair and shit. Throwing them off balconies and shit.
Right.
Hey. What we're saying is not out of the
No, it's not.
That's actually light.
This is the spirit of the Lord upon us speaking on, about these things, man.
That's right.
All
right,
crazy.
You gotta look at it like that, bro.
Crazy shit. All right, like that.
The Lord got the spirit upon us speaking about these things because they can really happen, man. Okay.
Yep.
You gonna see shit like that? Nobody's gonna have pity upon grandma, the neighborhood grandma. She done raised all these goddamn kids.
I know, right? Big mama.
Right, big mama. She done raised all these goddamn kids.
Raised all the 9, right. 10, 12 snotty-nosed ass grandkids.
Hey, grandma, one of those kids, all of them kids are going to be a bunch of Judas the Iscariots, man. I'm going to do something to you, grandma.
Oh, you said the video when the dude kicked his grandma?
he kicked his grandma.
And the dude kicked his grandma. Said, oh.
He kicked her. He said his hand threw it on the floor. Oh, fight, grandma.
Hey, you know, man, we live in a wicked ass world, man.
Yep, that's right.
We live in a wicked. So really, people's true intent is about to come out. Rushy, right now, you go to work. Come on, good morning. Hey, yeah, you know how you weekend. Yep. That shit fake, yep. Man.
That's right.
That shit ain't real.
Yep.
That shit is not real.
That's right.
Man, you brothers got precepts for it.
Bring it out, man.
I got 1 Peter 3:20, it says, which some time were disobedient, or when one's long surfing on the most side waited in the days of Noah, while the ark was a preparing, wherein few, that is, a souls were saved by water. Mm. Alright, so hey man, okay, we building the spiritual ark right now. Okay? Yep. So when that time comes, we won't have to worry about what's gonna happen, man. The woman won't gotta worry about that, man. Okay, we gonna be good. You know those other souls that were saved was because of Noah. Imagine if Noah ain't build the ark, man. What was gonna happen?
His whole family would have died. Sure. His whole family. His wife too. His children. Little Shem, man. You know?
Yeah.
That's why it's important for if you were a man, you gotta come work, man. Put your hand to that plow, whatever your lot is. Mm-hmm. You gotta work, man, so that you and your house can be saved.
Exactly. And another thing too, the back to your bar, I don't know if you're gonna say anything else.
No, yeah.
Another thing too, to back up the brother, you know, you gotta come and work, man. All right, you gotta come and get your hands dirty, man. All right, hey, be doers of the word and not hearers only. All right, you gotta come and get your hands dirty, man. And who gives a fucking Eve don't like it, man? If she wanna leave, let her leave.
She gonna die.
She's gonna die. All right, she let her leave. All right, let her go. Let her go, man.
You wanna fucking risk your salvation for her?
Fuck her. All right,
fuck
the Lord. The Lord will bless you. Will bless you, man.
We just read it. Isaiah 4:1.
Right. God damn it. The
Lord will bless you. That little stink ass gonna try to run back, man.
Right.
If she ain't already dead.
Right. She gonna try. She might try to run back and see you with, you know,
a whole line.
Right, a whole line. She might even see her best friend in the line. God damn it,
Shanika. Shanika gonna look at you like, girl, get out of this
room. Right. Girl, I don't know you.
Girl, get up. Girl,
right.
She might have to look at your ass.
Right.
I had a quick precept.
God damn it.
Back to brothers up. In Revelation chapter 3 and verse 11, it says, behold, I come quickly, hold thou fast, which thou hast,
that's right.
That no man take thy crown.
That's right.
So that no man is going into anybody. Mm-hmm. No, your woman. Your mother, your father,
your kids.
Right.
My baby girl, man.
Yeah.
My baby girl, man.
Right.
You know, man, hey, man, I got beat up for my baby girl, man. Hey, look. Hey, Lot was ready. Lot didn't look back for his damn kids.
Right.
His wife?
Yeah.
He said, man, look, I gotta get the fuck out of here.
That's right. That's right.
The Lord told him don't look back, and he ain't fucking look back.
That's right. That's right. Apostle Kyle, he did that video with Eli Ashwamba. I know y'all guys watched it. He did it with his son. Hey, Dad, you there a hoe. Fuck you, little
bitch. No, but that's the attitude you gotta have.
Right.
Not saying you actually say that to your son.
Right.
But that's the type of attitude you gotta have. If you don't have that type of attitude,
right,
you're gonna be willing to forsake the Lord.
Right.
You look, if your woman take your kids, and I'm gonna go take the MOTB. You gotta say, look, hey, hey man,
yep.
You better not take that shit.
Right.
You gotta be hard, man.
Come on, man. Like, this is the reality we in, man.
Yep. Hey man, you know. Shit. Hey, you brothers might have situations like that. Oh, Dad, you never home. Shit, you know, you might be in the flesh like, damn, you know, it might hurt you, but, bro, you got a job to do. You didn't come here to have fun, bro.
Yeah,
you came here to, like we were saying, you came to deliver a package,
right.
Then check out. Then when you check out, that's when you go home and you breathe and you relax.
That's right.
You put your feet up and you're just a big,
That's right.
All right?
You're going to be able to chill in the kingdom.
Exactly, man.
You can't even really enjoy your kids.
Here
anyway.
Right.
Yeah,
these demonic ass children. Bro.
Talking about non-binary and all this gender bullshit, man.
Right.
You gotta go.
It said 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 3. Therefore endure hardness as a good soldier for Yahweh Mashiach.
That's right.
So you gotta be hardened, man. That's especially right. For the times that we're coming into right now. You can't be some simp, man. That's why the scripture says put away from the immoral thoughts. Mm-hmm. You know?
That's right.
Yeah, man, put aside that weak nature.
That's right.
You know, you're a man. You got to gird up the loins of your mind.
Yeah. Right. Your woman should already know Saturdays are off limits.
Yes,
oh,
right.
Yeah. She should already know that.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
She should already have that understanding. The rest of my life, possibly, I'm never going, you know?
Right.
Look, she should already know that. And if she don't, she gonna fight, figure it out.
Right.
Until we get up out this motherfucker, man.
That's
oh,
right.
Yeah, yeah. He going to church. So you build your schedule around my motherfucking life.
That's right. That's right.
That's what a woman's supposed to do anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You build your life around me.
That's right.
I'm your everything, man. See, this world is all fucked up.
Right.
Where you build, you trying to maneuver your, you know, I ain't saying be a lion.
Right.
You know, but she's supposed to conform to you.
That happy wife, happy life bullshit.
Shit. She's supposed to conform her life to you.
Right. If not, if she don't want to get down.
She don't want to get down?
Fuck it.
Hey, man.
You know, if you get that random, you know, and she's like, if she just tell you out of nowhere, I just can't do this.
I can't do this anymore.
Fuck you. Leave.
I can't do this anymore, man.
Okay. Well, shit. I'm sorry for you.
Hey, we speaking from experience, man. Right. I've been through the shit.
Right.
Hey, look, man, I told my woman, look, man. This is what it's gonna be. If you wanna leave, you can leave, man.
Right.
Yep. And if the Lord want her to stay,
she gonna stay.
She gonna stay.
Right.
If that's your woman, he gonna have you rock out with. That's what the Lord want, man.
Right. If she gonna leave, let that bitch leave and
let her go.
Is either the Lord gonna have mercy or is she gonna get judged, man? Just keep doing what you gotta do, man. All right, so you can receive salvation.
Ecclesiastes, otherwise known as Sirach 25:26. Verse 26, if she go not as thou wouldest have her, mm-hmm. cut her off from thy flesh and give her a bill of divorce and let her go. So it said if she go not as thou wouldest have her, so it's a call to your way. You the man.
That's right.
You supposed to lead.
That's right.
You can't let a woman lead you. You supposed to lead.
You the head for the reason.
Right, so if she go not as you would have her go, hey, the scripture saying what it's saying, man. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Right, you're right.
On this first Ezra 4:25, before a man loved his wife better than father or mother, yet there many there be that went out of their wits for women and become servants for their sakes. Right? That's not how it's supposed to be, especially as a man of the Lord and you know your priorities, man. Okay, this truth is everything, man. How about Shema Shai is everything, man? Okay. 27, men also have perished. Many also have perished and erred and sinned for women. Right. That's how niggas go out because they ain't women, man. Okay, grab your balls, man. Okay, you a man. Okay, you're not supposed to be serving your woman. Your woman is supposed to be serving you. Yeah, she's called a helpmate for a reason, to help right. you.
Right. Yeah, talk about partner. Brothers, we ain't got no fucking partners. Right. I don't care if she's paying half of the rent. I don't give a fuck. The Lord ain't create us a fucking partner.
Right.
He created us a helpmeet.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Nothing changes that.
Right.
That's the way the Lord set it up.
I didn't make it up.
Right. You say a partner, you're trying to be equal.
Exactly. We ain't partners.
It ain't nothing equal, bro.
We ain't partners.
It's not equal, bro.
You say you love the Lord, you love the scriptures, the Bible, but when you bring that precept out,
a good cut.
They ain't want to be a helpmate.
Because they wicked. Because they wicked. Because
right.
they're wicked.
Right.
They're wicked. If they don't want to be they're wicked, man. Here it is. I don't want to be what God created me to be. You got a fucking spoon, but the spoon want to be a fork. What do you do? Throw that shit away and go get another one, man.
You got a hammer, you don't want a hammer. Throw that shit away, man.
You got the fuck, if the screwdriver.
Yeah, get the hammer that's going to be a hammer.
Right. Shit, what the fuck? Let's say you get a fucking spoon and the spoon split in three and I want to be a fork. Right. Guess what you do with the fork?
Right.
I'm trying to eat cereal, so I can't fucking use you, man.
Right. Right. you might get mad with the fucking fork.
You dripping by juice.
You might gosh, like,
throw that shit in the trash, man.
Right.
I'm trying to hold my cereal on the juice. Right. You dripping my juice, nigga.
Right. God damn it.
You know, we getting back in order as men, so the Lord gonna turn this thing right side up, man.
I got a scripture on that order.
What you got?
Yeah, I'm really
1 Corinthians 11:3.
I had it.
You guys,
bring it up,
bro. Go ahead.
You got something quick?
Yeah, that's quick. This is Job chapter 38, verse 3. It says, Gird up now thy loins like a man, mm-hmm. for I will demand of thee and answer thou me. You know?
Yeah, that's it. You got to be a man about it, man.
Yeah, that's right.
And the Lord dealing with men.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord dealing with men, and you as a man deal with your woman. You said you had that precept?
I got one more. I
can read it, bro. Like the brother just read through, that's the spirit. Because the Lord said, gird up your loins, I will require of thee. He wasn't speaking to no woman. He was speaking to Job.
Right.
He was speaking to a man.
Yeah.
The scriptures say, Revelation 21:3. Okay, the Most High deal with men, man.
Right.
The scripture, what he said, my words are unto the sons of men. Right.
Oh, okay. You men are called.
Right. So he said, the Most High ain't dealing with you, woman. Shit. I mean, you his people, you of Israel, yeah, but you deal to us.
That's right.
I'm your Lord.
Yeah. And the Lord's delights let me read it right quick. This is Proverbs chapter 8, verse 31. Rejoicing in the habitable part of his earth, and my delights were with the sons of men.
There you go.
Okay. So.
There you go. That's right.
Sons of God.
Right.
Sure. Yashar Allah.
Yep.
There you go. Prince of the power.
There are no princesses of the power.
Right. We never had a prince or a queen in Israel.
Daughters of God.
Israel.
There's no daughters of God.
Yeah. It's like enough prince. Princess.
Right.
We didn't have a princess or a queen in all Israel. We had all kings.
Right.
The kingdom of heaven. When you look up the word kingdom.
Right.
King.
But a king's rule.
Right.
Bro. The Lord.
You're saying a nation of kings and priests.
Right.
Then say kings and princesses.
No.
You can't get around it.
Man, right. The kingdom is for the nation of Israel, but first and foremost, for the men of Israel.
That's right.
The kings, man. And see, in Israel, we come first. In this world, the women come first, the dog, the children.
Right.
And that's in this world.
Everything come first.
See, but in the world, when it turns back up, we going to eat first.
That's right.
We going to drink first.
That's right.
Everything first for us.
Right.
Forever.
Right.
The word for that is called gynocracy. Look that word up, gynocracy. That's a woman-led world. A world where woman is in rulership.
This is the
can't last.
This is
the gynocracy. It can't last.
But the kingdom of heaven ain't gonna be that.
No.
Because Yahushua will get his plate first.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, no.
He's gonna get his wine, his plate first.
Right. Before any.
We gonna follow. Before any woman.
Right.
Yeah.
The woman go eat last, man.
Right.
Oh, woman get to play, you feed the kids. I was at a restaurant the other day, Sunday, and the motherfucker, the server was a faggot, man. Oh, I'm gonna take the woman's order first. Motherfucker? This, she ain't paying for this. You know what I'm saying? What, it's just like, you know, that little shit like that, just like, right. You know, I gotta remind myself, this not my world, man.
Right.
This not my world.
I'm gonna take the woman's order first.
And he knew that would bother me because he smirked. Like, he smirked with it. He would take the woman's order first.
Right. He was a demon,
Fucking. And he said, oh, if that's okay with you. You know, you try to be civilized, man.
Hey, let me ask you a question. Did you tip?
I ain't tipped that. Hey, you know what's funny? He didn't even continue serving me. Yeah. I looked at him, motherfucker, man. You know what I'm saying? It's a fucked up world, man. Yeah, this not our world.
This is a fucked up.
This not our world. This not our world. It's not for us, man. We gonna enjoy the kingdom, man.
That's right. And the kingdom's not gonna be boring. All right.
I know.
Fuck, bro. All right. We gonna live it up, man. Every day is gonna be a great fucking day. Man.
Every day.
You gonna wake up every day, jump out of your bed with a smile on your face.
Ah, which wife would I go to next? All
right.
How about that?
Right. Which wife gonna come and clean the royal penis today?
That's right. All right.
Fuck that, man. Okay.
Wife for every day of the week.
Right.
Every day of the year.
Right.
If we want, man.
That's right.
Because that's how kings rule.
Right.
Kings do what they want.
Nowadays, you wake up. You wake up to a alarm. You wake up to the black woman. With a bonnet on her head, all type of shit.
All type of crazy shit.
You wake up to snotty head Johnny. Hey, Dad, what are we gonna do today? What's going on, sir?
Yo,
Dad, this one out of ops, man.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
But hey, man, shit, we gotta keep fighting, man. We gotta keep fighting. Hey, we almost out of here, man.
That's right.
And another thing, too, our Father wants to give us the kingdom.
Luke, it's your Father's good pleasure to give you kingdom.
Yep, Luke, I believe. I think
the Lord actually wants to give us the kingdom.
That's right.
But we have to wait because everything is on the clock.
That's right.
We got to just wait for all the prophecies to be fulfilled.
That's right. I think like Luke 12 and 32 or 23, something like that. I think it is Luke 12, though.
God, that's so include.
I got one I've been holding.
Wait. It's 32.
This is Luke.
This is Luke 12, verse 32. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
That's right.
Talk about the elect, man.
That's right.
He ain't talking to everybody. He said little flock. The elect are a little flock.
That's right. That's
he ain't talking to the whole world, nation of Israel, man.
That's right.
You're going to have regular citizens in Israel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just regular civilians, which is nothing wrong with that. But, you know, we want to live it up.
Yeah. I done caught hell. I done went through it on this side. I want to literally have fun, you know? I want to have a chance to have fun, man. That's why we're going hard, and we know what we have to do to please the Lord, so it can pay off. You know, you ever had a day as a child or as a grown-up, you had a hard working day, but at the end of the day, you were able to relax, man, mm-hmm. All right? You were able to relax. I even see with my nieces and nephews, they wake up, all right? They do what they got to do. They get homeschooled, but eventually, when it's time for them to relax, they relax, man, because they did what they had to fucking do, man. Okay, and that's the same thing with us, man. We're sons, all right, to the Father, and we have to do what Dad says. So at the end of the day, we can be rewarded for our hard work. Okay.
Yeah, I appreciate that. This is Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. But seek ye first the kingdom of the Most High and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you.
That's right.
That's what we're doing right now.
Yeah.
We're seeking the kingdom of the Most High, preaching, exhorting brothers,
yep.
Bringing out prophecy.
Yep.
We could have been doing anything on a Wednesday, man, here in Miami.
Right.
You know? Right. So the Lord, he's looking at all this, man. Mm-hmm. Brothers sacrificing their time, their resources. The Lord looks at all that, man.
That's right.
We're forward in the kingdom of heaven because we want the kingdom.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right, man.
I got to be there. Right. 2 Ezra 8:52, for unto you is paradise open, the tree of life is planted, the time to come, prepared, Plenteous is made ready, a city is builded, and rest is allowed. Ye perfect goodness and wisdom. Right, this is what we want, man. Paradise, man. Ain't no paradise in Babylon. Ain't no paradise on this earth. As long as Esau's in power, there is no paradise.
Right.
Okay, so when the kingdom come and we turn into kings, okay, and the judges of the earth, then paradise is open. Then we could be able to relax and rest.
Right.
Cause there ain't no rest here, man.
Yep. And once the profitable one comes into authority,
right.
All right. Once he comes into authority, which is Yahweh Shai, once he comes into authority, hey man, we're gonna vibe the fuck out, man. Ain't gonna be no more teaching our brother. Nope. Ain't gonna be no more prophesying. Ain't gonna be none of that. Man.
Ain't gonna be no text from your woman, hey baby, you know where
right.
you at?
Right.
It's getting kind of late.
Right.
ain't gonna be none of that.
Ain't gonna be no none of that. Ain't gonna need to worry about. My kids been all fucking day. Nah, man. Our kids gonna be fucking living the fuck up, man. I ain't gonna need to worry about my son. All right, I'm gonna be on this planet. He gonna be on that planet, man.
Yeah, you ain't gotta worry about no pedophiles.
Right. None of that shit, man. Okay, I ain't gonna need to worry about a fucking ice cream truck coming. You got candy, you got Wi-Fi, you need Wi-Fi, you need candy, and your kid's gone, man.
This is a sick world we live in, though.
Right, man.
I've literally seen people in the mall, they can't let their child hand go.
Yep.
Because, you know, a split second of somebody grabbing kids in broad daylight.
Yep.
I see the story where they had some kids get poisoned, they eat some candies laced with poison. They found the candy around their house. I forget where it was exactly. But they found the candy around their house area, and you know little children, they eat the candy.
Right. Right.
But the candy was laced with poison.
Come on.
So that's like something premeditated.
When the righteous are in authority, yeah. The people rejoice. But when the wicked barrel, the people mourn.
Right.
Yeah, man.
I gotta put some precepts.
Just say it again, brother. Hey, in the kingdom, we ain't gonna need to be. Here is when we stop preaching the word, man. Yep. We ain't gonna need to preach the word. Once again, we just say name these things. We ain't gonna need to preach the word no more. Teach our neighbor. Ain't gonna need to worry about our children. And so on and so forth, man. We're gonna really be able to live it the fuck up, man. All right? We're gonna really have the time of our lives, man, forever.
That's right.
All right?
You ain't looking at your watch, damn, you know.
Right.
I gotta go to work in the morning. Right. I only gonna get 6 hours.
Right.
No. Ain't gonna be none of that.
None of that, man.
Ain't gonna be nothing.
You ain't gonna need to worry. Hey, the curse is gonna be done away with. Yep. You ain't gonna need to worry about waking up. All right, because what the curse say? You get up. You hoping for nighttime. Uh-huh. Then nighttime, you hoping for the morning. All right. You ain't gonna need to worry about that no more, man. All right, curse is gonna be done away with as well, man. Okay. Hey, man. Hey, we ain't fighting for nothing little. Okay. That's Romans the 8th chapter. You know, go ahead, Omar.
I got 2 Peter chapter 3 and verse 13 and 14. It says, nevertheless, we are called to his promise. Look for new heavens and a new earth,
yep.
Wherein dwelleth righteousness, which is the kingdom, right? Mm-hmm. It says, wherefore, beloved, seeing that ye look for such things, be diligent that ye may be found of him in peace, without spot and blameless. So, they go that word diligent again. Be diligent, man. This is what you have to do. That's part of the walk. That's part of the journey.
Mm-hmm.
You know, being pleasing unto the Lord by being diligent.
That's right.
Okay? To make your calling and election sure.
That's right.
That's what we got to do. Because we're looking for such things as the kingdom of heaven. The Most High ain't dealing with just a digger. You know? The Most High think he loves none that him who dwells with wisdom. You know? That's how you're going to be able to discern things. Isaiah 33 and 6, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. You gotta be in these scriptures. Mm-hmm. That's how we're going to get the kingdom. So it's better part of your Abba Shinam Shai.
That's right.
Yeah, you got to do it.
Mm-hmm. Sure. I got a quick one. This is Romans 8 and 17. And if children and heirs of the Most High, and joint heirs with Mashiach, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. Verse 18, this is the point. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. So what we're going through right now should not even be compared to everything we're about to
receive, man. Okay? We go, you know, yeah, we go through shit, you know. And hey, you know, we go through shit here, you know. It bothers us, but bro, what we going through ain't shit to everything we about to receive, man. And one main thing we about to receive is never dying again. Alright? And so on and so forth. Never dying again, the women in order, children in order, you in order, okay? And so on and so peace, okay? Yeah. All your enemies ain't none of them on top of you.
Yep.
All of them beneath you, okay?
That's a real blessing.
Come on, man. You better got it.
I got to preach in the back of what you was just saying. This is Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 11. It says, now no chastening for the present seeming to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward it yielded the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. So like you just said, we go through what we're going through now, but it's going to yield the peaceable fruit.
That's
and that fruit is going to be the first fruits, the elect, which is going to be, we're going to have the kingdom of heaven forever. Okay, joint heirs with our Lord Yahweh Shai. So what we're going through right now is a chastising, you know. But hey, the Lord said he deal with us as he deal with sons, else we would be bastards. Mm-hmm. The scripture said, Lord, chasten those whom we love.
You chasten Yahweh Shai.
There you go.
Right. We chasten Yahweh Shai. So I mean, shit, we got to be chastening with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
That's right, bro. That's right.
Elect, just a big, it's a big, just a big family reunion again.
Right.
Because that's when the elect are. Yahweh Shai created the elect.
That's right.
So all it is just, you just were coming right back to him.
Yeah. That's right.
You know, just like, oh, what's up, man? You know, I remember I created you. You know.
Mm-hmm.
That's all it is, man.
That's right.
Just everything just coming back.
That's right.
Yeah. It's in John the 17th chapter, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Fruits. Go ahead, bro.
This is Matthew 26 and verse 28. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of the fruit of wine until that day which I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.
Go ahead, break it down.
He's talking about Yahweh Shai, man, you know. You know, he's waiting for us so he can drink wine with us, man. You know, that's probably that all we endure. No one will be saved, man. You know?
So what?
You don't want to miss that.
Right.
I know no brother want to miss that.
Right.
I don't want to miss that. I want to be up in that room when everybody giving that toast.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Corn,
right.
That's around the bubble ball.
Right.
Ooh, I don't want to miss that.
I don't want to miss that.
That's
I want to partake of that. Okay.
Crown.
That's right. The first resurrection.
Yeah.
You ain't got to come back as a baby.
Wow. Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't want to go. I want to tell you. I want to see this.
Right.
Hey, why?
I ain't trying to come back as a... I'm trying to make it, man.
Yeah.
All right?
Uh-huh.
That should be the mindset of all of us brothers, man. Uh-huh. All right? You want to make it, man. You don't want to die, man.
Well, even if you do die a righteous death, you know, you coming back.
Right.
But I'm saying, you know, I understand what you brother saying, you know.
Right.
You don't want to be a two-third.
Yeah, basically, you don't want, what I mean is basically you don't want to die of the fire.
Exactly.
That's what I mean.
You don't want to be touched that second death?
Second.
Revelation chapter 20 and verse 6.
Yep.
It says, blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection.
Mm-hmm.
On such the second death hath no power.
That's the elect.
Right.
The first fruits.
For they shall be priests of the Most High and of Hamashiach, and shall reign with him 1,000 years.
That's the setting up of the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
That's the first resurrection.
Yep.
The setting it up.
Right.
Okay, here are your slaves. Your slaves over here. This is your part of the earth, the universe here. Kingdom, clean this shit up, heathens, and build this up. We want this here, that. You know, everything going to be structured, organized, setting up the government.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yep. You don't want to miss that. You hear it is, you came out, you know, righteous man nuts, and all everything all built.
Right.
You know, I want to see it faster.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Oh, yeah.
No, you missed that. Fucking place this, man. Move that shit over there.
Just think about it. Just think about the wrong fire, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
See, that's what the Lord about to give us.
give me that.
Shit, Revelation 2?
No, no, he got it. Okay. Psalms 2nd chapter. You can give me that in Revelation 2. Mm-hmm. Psalms 2. Were you 10, 9?
Shit, you can start like verse 7 or 8, I think. Go on.
This is Psalms 2 and verse 7. I will declare the decree, the Lord Yahweh have said unto me, thou art my son, this day I have begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee heathen for thy inheritance, and the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession. Mm-hmm. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. Mm-hmm. Thou shalt dash them in pieces.
That's talking about in the kingdom, man. Mm-hmm. We're gonna kick their ass.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna literally beat the living shit out of them.
Hand their asses to them.
That's what we're gonna do. Read that again.
Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron.
We're gonna break them with the rod. Go with our scepters.
That's right.
King got a scepter. We're gonna be crushing them. Yep. Remember, because they're gonna be human. Mm-hmm. We're gonna be crushing them in the skull, beating them down to the.
Right, yeah, you ever play, with the arcade?
You just whack them all.
That's what we're gonna do.
The Bible says that. Go ahead.
Thou shalt dash them in pieces.
We're gonna have a sword. We're gonna cut them in half. Brothers, this is what we fight for, man. This is a righteous thing.
That's right.
Seeing it is a righteous thing to recompense them that troubled you.
That's right.
That's a righteous thing. They did it to us. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Like a potter's vessel.
Like a potter's vessel. You're going to have power like that. Because those heathens are going to belong to you.
Go ahead. Be wise now, therefore.
That was the point. You're going to get that in Revelation.
Yeah. Come on. Now, I just want to bring this up before I grab that Revelation. This is 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
That's record. What they call that's true reparations.
That's right. Shit, I'm reading LLT. In his justice, he will pay back those who punish you.
Pay back. The biggest payback ever. Mm-hmm. The plowman shall overtake the reaper.
That's right. Uh-huh. That's right, brother. Come on. This is Revelation chapter 2, and I'll start at verse 25. Revelation 2 and 25. But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. Power over the nations. Mm-hmm. Okay? And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
A strong, that means you're going to rule with rigor.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. You ain't going to be nice.
That's right.
You ain't going to be nice. You ain't going to be smiling at your heathens. Right. You're going to tell them, get there and do this and do that.
Right.
And if you can't do it, whack.
Right.
Whack.
When you finish reading verse 27, read it in that LT.
Come. Verse 27, again, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my father.
Yep. He received that in the Psalms, the 2nd chapter. Mm-hmm. He just quoted Psalms 2.
Yep.
Because he was talking to his father. His father said, I'm going to give you this, son.
Right. That's right. So I'm going to read verse 27 in the NLT. Revelation 2 and 27 in the NLT. They will rule the nations with an iron rod and smash them like clay pots. So like a clay pot. Damn. In a clutch. You know, shit.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Brother, you're going to be...
You think about a clay pot, it's like, shit.
So, but this is what the pastor, they don't tell you.
Right.
That you're going to be able to have slaves and beat people down.
They never bring them scriptures out.
No.
They don't understand it.
Who you call Jesus Christ? Well, Jesus Christ about to break, crack people's skulls.
You ain't talking about my Jesus.
Not mine.
You ain't talking about my Jesus.
Oh, yes. Oh, it's coming back in a big way. Big so-called black men with crowns on their head. That's a cracker worst nightmare.
Right.
Big black men with an iron and a rock.
And we're gonna fuck up these heathens. I looked up a clay pot, you see some shit like this, you just drop on the floor of
break.
Fragile.
Yeah.
We're gonna fuck up these heathens.
They're gonna be fragile because we're gonna be gods.
Right. Yep.
We're gonna get our stature.
your back.
Yep.
Our hands are gonna be large.
Yep.
So we're really. Whoa! We're gonna be gods again, man.
That's right.
We're gonna be gods. We're gonna be able to smack a whole line of slaves in space. Wow!
What? You're right. You might see a slave on your land. You just point at him, and he just start flying, and he starts disintegrating, man. All right.
Yeah. People don't believe this, but you know the scriptures tell you this, man.
Yep.
You know, brother got some.
Yeah. This is Psalm 149. Yeah. This is Psalm chapter 149, verse 7. It says to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishments upon the people, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron.
Fetters of iron. What are those? Those are the chains, man. Mm-hmm. The neck. You know, when you type in, possible, to her, I always say this. When you
yoke
type
iron.
Yoke of iron. What are we going to put? The yoke of iron on them.
Yep.
We're going to put a yoke of iron around their neck, their hands, their feet. Moab, Ishmael, all the heathens. It's going to be a whole bunch of their ass. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a lot of heathens.
Especially the elites.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You're going to have, they're going to be very quiet.
That's right.
I mean, other than when they get in their heads, no, it's gonna be no talk, just build.
Right.
No talking to each other.
Right.
You know?
Mm-hmm. I got Isaiah 24.
No friendship.
Either. No friendship, nothing else. Yeah. Just build.
Just work,
motherfucker.
Work,
man. You know, Moab, simple that. Ain't gonna be no fucking chicken fried rice in the kingdom, man.
Right.
And then that bull, you cooking it a rat.
Right. No cooking cat. Alright. And you fucking have bites. No washing your fucking hand with fucking cow piss, man. No boiling dogs, man. We gonna eat.
Hey, we gonna kick y'all ass.
Right. Yeah. Yes.
Because they're still gonna have that in them. They're gonna be human.
Yeah, yeah.
So they're still going to have those lust desires, but we're literally going to break them into submission.
That's right.
We're going to know what they're thinking. Oh, damn, I wish I had a dog. What? What?
Yeah.
They're not going to think like us. So they're going to think in their flesh. They're still going to be a heathen.
Yeah, that's right.
So we're going to have to beat them into what we want them to be. Mm-hmm. The same way he did it does. What's your name? Toby. He beat that name into him.
Right.
Well, guess what? We're gonna beat them into righteousness.
That's right. He destroyed that. He destroyed him. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Toby.
Go. Who's reading?
Well, Kabari was reading.
No, I don't know.
Isaiah 24 said, "It shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall punish the host of the high ones that are on high." Talking with the elites, and the kings of the earth upon the earth, and they shall be gathered together as prisoners are gathered in the pit, and shall be shut up in the prison, and after many days shall they be visited. So this is going to play out in reality, man. It's a prophecy, a future prophecy.
That's right.
To the elite, those of you that are destroying the earth, mm-hmm. You know?
All the fucking devils will be chained up, man.
Yeah. A lot of them, they're going to escape the oncoming destruction in their bunkers, only to be rounded up later on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of them motherfuckers old and shit.
But they old ass, but they're going to go first. Slavery.
You're going to pick up them goddamn boulders.
Yeah.
Right.
That you're going to pick it up, and you're going to work, motherfucker, until you drop dead.
Bring you back.
You drop dead. You're going to work. Man, it's gonna be a lot of work done in the kingdom. Because brothers like extravagant, nice things on this side. So imagine when they get the full capacity of their devil over. Motherfuckers gonna be building forever.
Right. We Israelites, baby. We Israelites, man.
Go ahead, you bring that up. This, you got some?
Nah.
Okay, then that'd be the last one.
Okay. And it's Isaiah 60:14. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee. Mm-hmm. And all they that despise thee shall bow themselves at the soles of thy feet.
Woo! You know what that means?
They're going to be bowing down.
They're going to be bowing down to you, meaning their face to the earth. Mm-hmm. Like this.
Don't look at
me. And they ain't going to look at you in your eye.
That's right.
My Lord.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That's what we got coming, man.
Mm-hmm.
The kingdom, man.
That's right.
the city of the Lord Yahweh, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. All right, so that's what's coming to us. That's what's coming for us, man. You know, these heathens, these elites bowing down to us. These heathens bowing down to us. So we're gonna be in that godlike mentality, everything, man. Right. We're just gonna be godlike, man.
That's right. We're gonna be, oh, give me that Zechariah, close out with that Zechariah 14, man.
Yep.
You know, we're gonna be godlike again, the sons of God, the sons of the power.
That's right.
The Most High, we're gonna represent the Most High on earth.
That's right. That's right, brother.
Because the heathens have never seen the Most High.
Never.
We are gonna see the Most High. We're gonna literally see him. The heathens, they'll never see the Most High. Never. They ain't gonna never see the Most High, man. We're his children, we can't see him now.
Right.
So you think they're gonna see him in captivity with curses on him? Hell no, man. Go ahead, bro. What did I say again? Zechariah 14. He that is feeble among them.
That's verse 10. I forgot the verse that is. That's Zechariah 14 or
that's 12? Yeah, that's 12 or 4, 12.
I think it's
12. Slavia, 12.
Is it 12? It
should be 12. 12 or 14, one of them.
It was.
I always get it mixed up.
Right, damn.
I don't know why. I just wanted to prove that point.
It's
12 and 8.
Zechariah 12:8.
In that day shall the Lord Yahweh defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and he that is feeble among them at that day shall be as David, and the house of David shall be as the Most High, and as the angel of the Lord Yahweh before them.
So brothers are gonna be likened unto the Most High, likened unto the powers,
many Most Highs.
That's what we're gonna be.
That's right, man.
Power. We're going to get it back. You know, that's a whole other topic.
Yeah.
But that's what we got, man. The kingdom, baby.
That's right.
Godlike.
That's right.
The sons of the Most High. Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah. I'm going to take us home, baby.
Hey, so with that, hopefully we're all edified. We're going to go ahead and give all honor and glory and praise unto
Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai Ba'ashim, Rekapadash.
Double honors to the elders and apostles of great Millstone who taught us this truth and rule well. Salutations to the brothers out there that are laboring and pushing this truth and in sincerity and in charity, risking their lives and their freedom to do so. With that, Shalom.
Shalom.
Baba Bob.
Baba Bob.
Barmi Asherala.
Barmi Asherala.
Shalom.
Shalom.